So they're going to have the Naga Ancient Apparition. Are they going to pick up the Disruptor? I think that's sort of what the plan is here.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. And I mean, Virtus Pro Polar are not going to pick that hero, I don't think.
Do you think that
be very surprised.
You ban Disruptor in the second phase against Secret? They've had so much success, especially with the Ancient Apparition combination.
I think after that last game yesterday, the Disruptor, and even after the last game they just played, probably. Yeah, I think the hero's pretty good. I think No-Tail is pretty good with that hero, but the problem with that is like if you don't ban out the Disruptor, or if you ban out the Disruptor, maybe that leaves the option for Elder Titan or Io, which, by the way, they ban out both of those heroes, so.
Yeah, I believe they're like 14-2 with Disruptor, so. Pretty insane set. Although, I mean, they have a very high win rate in general. I believe like something like 75 or something crazy.
Something gross.
But yeah, they are very good with this Disruptor here. And it seems to be the comfort supports for Team Secret right now, the Ancient Apparition with the Disruptor. It makes their laning phase extremely strong. They can, you know, farm up these supports. They both scale well into the late game with their respective Aghanim Scepter upgrades. And I mean, don't change what isn't broke. Or don't
someday
fix
we're gonna
what
see.
Isn't.
We're gonna see Puppy break out the Chenor Enchantress one day, and that day, like maybe there's a buff that happens to Chenor Enchantress, and all of a sudden it just gets absurd again, and then they have an even wider hero pool. But as of right now, nobody plays those heroes. I don't know if the Chen buff was that great. I think it was pretty good, but
well, I mean, the two creeps at level 3 is very significant. It makes your ganking potential that much stronger, but I think these two heroes just struggle to find their footing in the metagame right now just because of the length of games. You know, had this change happened, you know, with the old towers and stuff, I think both heroes would be exceptionally strong, but in the current place that Dota is at, I'm not sure that you really have room for heroes like Chen and Enchantress, because sure, you might get an early game, but both heroes tend to fall off towards that late game, and with most games going 40 to 50 minutes, is it really worth picking such a hero?
That's the question, man. That really is truly the question. Shadow Feed for Team Secret. Radiant was not anticipating this pick. Wow, okay. I think Naga Siren with the Song of the Siren comboed up with the Shadow Fiend Requiem of Souls is pretty good. And he also just can go toe-to-toe like no other hero with 36 souls, Presence of the Dark Lord, immediate armor reduction. Are they styling on them?
Is this like a pick?
Is this just, what is this?
Yeah, I mean, a couple teams have tried picking SF. I know EG was picking it for a little bit with like Omni Knight. Mostly, I think it's because Arteezy likes the hero so much, and he's like, please pick this hero for me. I really want to play SF. They actually, I believe, thought it was very strong, though, with the Omni Knight. If you can protect SF, I think he's one of the, you know, he's a really strong hero in the mid game. He does sort of tail off into the late game because he gets his six items so fast, and he doesn't really have the skill set to carry like some of these other heroes, like a Naga Siren. But when you pair it with the Naga, you're pretty much guaranteeing the late game at that point, so if Shadow Fiend can carry you in that mid-game phase, then I think it's a fine pickup, but it is a very difficult matchup in the mid lane against the Puck. If it is indeed a carry Naga Siren, it could just be a carry Shadow Fiend.
They think it's a support Naga Siren, by the way, for Virtus Pro Polar. They've banned out the Juggernaut, so they assume that this Naga Siren is a support, and I think that's an okay assumption.
I mean, it's a flex pick, right? So it could be a support or a carry at this point, and maybe they're just not comfortable playing against the Jug again. It did work last game, and the healing ward against Venomancer, I think, is very potent. I like this Jug ban.
It makes sense. Virtus Pro Polar, 9 seconds left of reserve time. They have to pick their second support unless they want Veno in that spot, which I highly doubt will happen. So what is it going to be? Okay, it is Veno support. They pick up the Templar Assassin as well, so they want an even better matchup. And they have a lot of potent early, mid, and I guess even late game damage here through Templar Assassin. Refraction is going to be really good. Refraction from, like, Templar Assassin with Refraction against Shadow Fiend, it's a very tough matchup, so.
Yeah, TA definitely has a huge advantage against Shadow Fiend. We actually didn't even touch on the Shadow Fiend buff, so the Ray's now dealing 100 damage at level 1 and then scaling up to 325 at level 4, so outputting a decently large amount of damage, especially, and it one-shots the range creep, which is kind of important to note.
Secures you that extra bit of farm that you might be lacking because your level 1 necromastery isn't giving you the stats that it wants.
Occasionally you miss the range creep because your second raise doesn't connect on all the creeps, and then the creeps actually just kill it because it's at 1 HP. But now that can never happen, so... And it's also kind of nice when they're pushing into you and you can just one-shot them, not having to get in range for that secondary race, so... It's a pretty interesting change. I don't think it does too much for Shadowfiend, because I think he still has the same general problems. Which is, he's very easy to kill in the early game, and then his late game scaling is not up to snuff against these other heroes.
They have the Shadowfiend for the late game potential, but that's really it. The Centaur Warrunner will provide a bit. Misery's gonna play it in the offlane. Kuroki Batrider or Kuroki Shadowfiend? Kuroki Shadowfiend.
It's gonna be an aggro tri-lane if Misery's playing center, I think. It's an S4 bat. Never mind. Are we gonna have...
Okay. Shadowfiend.
I have no idea where these heroes are going. Okay,
we're gonna find out momentarily.
S4 actually has two branches, so most likely gonna be in the mid lane. So we're actually gonna see a mid lane Batrider up against this TA.
Dual lane with Kuroki going bottom, and then
that is
Misery top in the safe lane?
That's a matchup I haven't seen in quite some time.
The Bat versus the Templar Assassin.
The Bat versus TA, yeah.
Not bad if you can get some sticky napalms in, especially with the Firefly. But Illidan is going mid currently on the Venomancer. We have absolutely called these lanes 100% wrong. We're so good at our job.
Oh, they're going to safe lane TA. I think... Wow. They've actually... Okay.
FNG
I think it's
jungle. Okay.
All right. It's because S4 is on the Batrider, so they think S4 is going to be mid. I'm actually quite curious to see if maybe Secret don't actually put that mid.
No, but it's FNG jungle liking, by the way. Just throwing that out there.
Oh, what is going on?
This is you're so confused.
Insane.
You just
this
can't keep track
of
anything.
This is not what I was expecting. I actually like this coming out from Virtus Bro a lot. My only concern is that they get aggressive tri-lane and then this TA has a miserable time. And TA is not a hero that.
What
has
is FNG
going to
do on this late game if they get aggro tried? It's going to be nothing. This is what leagues look like. Yeah,
No.
You would
League
know
has,
about that.
No. League has the same lane setup every game. So I would not be confused if this was League.
You would know immediately. Misery actually might feed up first blood. Illusory Orb, Jaunt. Easy kill. They get Misery, who gets caught out of position. A bit ambitious going for that first bounty rune, but. Nonetheless, he will feed away first blood to, I believe, the Venomancer. So Illidan already getting off to a very fast start in this mid lane. And he buys a Sage's Mask, which he's getting his Basilius coming through. So he needs to buy a stick, actually, is what he needs to buy.
I mean, on the bright side, it does force Illidan to go for Gale in the mid lane, which is not something that you typically want to do. Usually you want to max out the Plague Ward's the Sting, Poison Sting first. So, and he also doesn't actually get the block either. So S4 is going to have a nice time in this early laning phase.
FNG went for Howl level 1 instead of the Wolves, and he has Tangos, so he's just going to Tango it up, use Howl to try to last hit a bit more efficiently and stay alive and just kill the creeps
faster. He's actually in the enemy jungle, which is actually quite smart, I think, when they aggro
to camp. No tail blocked to camp and realized he wasn't going to get a free lane, so yeah, they go for FNG up into the top lane. Kuroki should be okay down here. DK Phobos is going to have to get close until he has the side blades, and for the time being, it is it's an interesting lane, certainly. Yeah. I mean, Phobos has got to be careful.
I think it's actually quite fortunate for VPP that Illidan actually ended up with the first blood gold, because had that gone to Puck, I actually think that it would not have actually been worth it for Venomancer. Oh, he has 6 stacks on him. It's going to be 7. Oh, S4 maybe overextending.
S4 dodged too far. He's actually dead. The Venomous Gale might kill him. The Firefly and the right click. S4. It doesn't matter how many stacks you give him. He's going to Venomous Gale you underneath the tower, and he is slow. And they might find the courier as well, but FNG's too far away.
Well, that would have been huge had he gotten the courier as well. And, you know, S4 sort of baiting himself, gets up to the 7 sticky charges. Well, nice bait from Illidan, I suppose. But yeah, I think a little bit of an overconfident play from S4 to try to go for that kill.
He dove right past that tower, and even though he still has the CS lead, I mean, 2 kills already going for Illidan, provides him plenty of gold. Something's coming out. It is going to be boots, a stick. Actually, his full wand is done, by the way, so... Bottom lane, Haste Rune, I believe, for No Tail, looking for Phobos. Phobos does have both Meld and Refraction. I don't know if they have sentries or any detection down here. It looks like they do have sentries for Puppy, but the problem is taking off the Refraction charges. Again, at level 1, that's not an issue. Brokey, he's not going to get levels. This is the problem. Necromastery stacks might be kind of a big issue for him. He's going to stay at 13 currently, and then, well, 15, I should say, is the max level 1, and then go from there.
I actually think that VPP got a bit ahead in these lane matchups. The mid matchup of Veno versus Bat is definitely Veno favorite, I believe. And then I think had they put SF mid, they would have been a lot more happy with this lane setup, because SF is really a hero that needs a lot of levels.
Is SF dead again?
Gets the Gale off. I don't think he's dead yet.
Well,
oh,
FNG
wait, he might
here.
Be in trouble.
Right click. The Venomous Gale's going to wear off pretty soon. Yeah, he's going to get right click down. Bottling up. Firefly goes and Plague Ward. Bottle up again. He's still alive. And he does take down to the Poison Sting, I believe. And they got the kill.
Well, this is interesting. Illidan has a killing spree and 8 CS in the mid lane.
And Snare, Riptide. Lil is about to fall here to the right click of No Tail. He gets the kill. Wow. That Riptide armor reduction, though.
Excellent camera work. I completely missed that one.
Thank you.
So I was going off on a little tangent about Illidan and his 3 kills with 8 CS at 3 minutes.
I need that kind of justification because I always have nice camera noob in chat, so at least someone will commend me occasionally. But no, I catch the kills. FNG is also really low. He's rotated back to his own jungle and 600 gold in the bank. Yeah. He is doing an okay job with 7 CS. The more important thing was getting the kill, I think, on S4, so...
Yeah, I don't think people realize how difficult it is to actually control the camera while you're talking about other things, because you're not paying... You have to pay attention to what you're looking at, and then also the minimap as well. It's not as easy as it looks.
I'm not going to try to justify myself. FNG bought his bottle, he'll deny himself quickly, and go back home, so... Observer Ward placed down again on the... That's a really good Dire Observer Ward as well. That's going to give them plenty of vision. However, S4 is like, help, please. Plague Wards are assaulting me. I cannot farm. No Tail might try to go for a kill here. They're going to wrap around. TP's coming in mid as well. The Sticky Napalm's going in. S4 does not have Lasso. Gale did miss, by the way. Ensnare, Riptide, Cold Feet as well. Illidan is going to proc up, and he is dead. Cass comes in onto S4, but does not bounce through, and... And that is that's a pretty big kill, because that allows S4 to maybe clean up these wards, have Puppy help out as well, and go back to work.
Yeah, that's a nice game for them. They also get a bit of streak gold as well. 314 gold going towards S4 on the Batrider. Very important for him, as he was struggling in this mid lane. Actually, he already had two kills.
He needed the stick to come out. It's not like it's just the Venomancer because of the Sticky Napalm, but the stick against Plague Wards is huge, so...
Mm-hmm. Although he can cast them from a far enough distance to where he doesn't necessarily always get the magic wand.
What is that range on that, by the way, the stick range?
Oh, boy.
All right, well, listen, we're going to have Mopax. Mopax is going to figure that out. Don't you worry. We're going to focus on the game here. The Tri-Lane mid now coming out.
I know
it's
like from
the
feel, but I don't know the actual value.
He could feel the range. He can't talk about it, though.
Yep. I mean, that's how it works when you play. Like, a lot of times you don't actually know the actual value of things. Like, even people that are pro players, but you have a feel for like, how it works, and so you don't really need to know the actual value.
Thank you, Mopax. I appreciate it. See that? You were just stalling until that came up. Stampede mid lane. They're looking for a lasso. They are going to find it. Poison Nova does get off. Now the Chilling Touch comes out. The right click. Do they have the damage? And Snare goes out. Yep, Venomous Gale's going to go, but does nothing. S4 needs to avoid a lot of this tower damage. He should be okay. That Poison Nova, not long enough of a duration to be that effective. And they actually get the kill, although take heavy damage in the process.
Oh,
so.
Misery actually gets a kill in the top lane as well.
He got Lil, the Witch Doctor rotated up, and it looks like they were trying to kill him with Mag, but he is so low, he is to be careful. No, his Strangles are about to regenerate
here
momentarily.
Oh no, Mag is in trouble as well.
Mag is going to try to jaunt away, looks like he will get out.
There's no Firefly right now, so he's actually completely fine.
Puppy! Oh, the Wolf almost killed Puppy! He was so low, the Wolf was chasing him from the bottom lane, but not enough. And Virtus Pro Polar, despite having an advantage in terms of laning setup, Kuroki does have to go back home, and he was doing well for the time that he was tri-laning, but... Now you can see that Phobos is starting to catch up as well. So I think that Secret are actually doing very well for themselves. They have a slight gold advantage, very slight, and experience of advantage of about 500. So.
Mm-hmm.
That animation, though, with the Arcana from Kuroki. So much fire coming out. Literally Ragnaros.
He is level 6 now. Oh, come on. That's the wrong game.
Is it though?
Okay, so if we look at net worth, it's actually a very even game. There was a little bit of an advantage from VPP, but nothing too significant, and now it's pretty much evened up with those last few ganks from Secret. So even though Secret have a kill advantage, it's a fairly even game at this point.
And Kuroki finally getting that mid lane farm, which you see so often for a Shadow Fiend. He will have 36 stacks relatively soon.
Misery is getting close to that scary point once he gets up the blink dagger onto Centaur.
This will be a very early blink if he can get a couple more CS. He's about 900 gold away. Yeah. What is FNG accomplishing in the jungle? Bottle, boots, and a Quelling Blade stat shield.
I mean, he's actually not doing too bad.
Kuroki gets scaled to the mid lane, does take some poison sting damage as well.
Shapeshift,
he's gonna get run at. He has his salve, and he might need to use it at some point. He needs TP rotations. They're running there, but it's gonna be maybe too late. The stampede comes just in time for Misery. They're gonna try to turn their attention to Illidan. He gets in snare. Now they're looking on the side of. They actually didn't use the ensnare for the shapeshifted Lycan. Poison Nova goes out. Puppy might die. Dreamquill coming in as well. No Tail is going to try to CP out. Not going to make it. They actually get two kills. Both in the supports. S4 is still coiled up. Has lasso, but they can't fight here. Mag didn't come to the lane. It was a full four-man rotation as DK Phobos is still bottom. But really good fight coming out from Virtus Pro Polar. The Illidan Storm Rage Poison Nova. The Mag Dreamquill. The Shapeshift coming out. All of that successfully gets them a couple of kills.
Yep. And the Stampede was forced to be used in a defensive place to save Kuroki, but VPP have been doing quite nicely with this early game and the jungle Lycan, and pretty soon he's actually going to be quite a force in this game once he gets up his treads, the Vlads, as well as the Medallion. They can even sneak Roshan, like we always see. So that's going to put a lot of pressure onto Team Secret, and I would say they're on a bit of a timer with this draft that they've picked. They don't really have anything that scales too well into the late game. They have the Shadow Fiend, that's pretty much their primary damage source. Once they get the two blinks, the two blinks onto both the Batrider and the Centaur can be very scary for VPP, and it's just going to be about weathering that storm.
S4 has his coming out. Misery is 200 gold away, so it's 10 minute blink daggers for both of them.
Yeah, and this first Batrider gank is going to be extremely scary because of the Stampede. He can just lasso someone, blink lasso, get the Stampede off, move them about 1,200 units, and should be a very easy kill at that point.
Kuroki continues to take farm. Stampede top lane. Stomp's going to go. Illidan Stormrage double edge. They don't have the damage. That point booster and Tread saved his life in Misery. Tried to get the solo kill. Instead, if he dies here, there it is. He sold something, gets the blink dagger, and he's good. Mm.
He actually waited. He should have waited just a little bit, because S4, it looks like he wants to go on this top lane, but Misery going a bit too soon, and S4 not able to get an assist on that kill. They might find Lil here, or FNG, possibly.
One of the two heroes.
Two blink daggers, so.
I think Lil is probably the easier target to go for. FNG is the better target.
I think he's actually just dead here.
S4 Firefly, Shapeshift's gonna go in, Ice Blast is gonna come through, it's gonna connect, they need a blink stomp though, and they're going to find it. Double Edge, it is enough, that is a big kill. S4 and Misery, they're gonna get cast, they're gonna stay together for a moment, but they're fine.
You know, that was actually quite close to FNG living there. It had the cast bounce to Misery before he was able to get the Double Edge off. I think FNG probably would have lived with that movement speed from the Shapeshift, so. Yeah. Nice play coming up from Secret, though, identifying that they could actually get the kill onto FNG's Lycan, as it was a better kill than the Witch Doctor.
What about DK Phobos? Phase Boots, Bracer, no, is now getting room. He is level 6, by the way, so this is, again, what Secret do very well in getting supports up levels. TP, Misery, got Venomous Kill, and I think he got Poison, but he just TPs away. That is a mid counter to the Venomancer. Hey, I actually just have a TP, you can't kill me, so.
13-1 when he gets a blink before 10 minutes.
Man, I wonder what that one game was where he didn't win that game. That's
although he did play it in an era where Bat was kind of broken. To be fair.
Yes.
I think everyone had good stats with Bat back then. Not saying that S4 isn't an exceptional Bat, but.
What are you implying here?
Nothing.
Kuroki continuing to farm up 1,400 gold in the bank. A little bit of a line has been drawn with No Tail and Misery. They're going to wrap currently onto DK Phobos, who's currently in the jungle. They have a very good idea of where he is. They drew a line directly into Phobos. He's going to walk to the low ground. He is maybe going to get jumped on. Song first. They actually want to pick up the Sin of his rune. Or they just want to kill him. Ice Blast? Ensnare?
Oh, they missed.
They have sentries. Yeah, they're going to get this kill. Meanwhile, top lane, S4 is in some trouble. They use the coil, they're actually going for the tower as well. Plague wards have already been placed down, and S4 gets blown up. They threw the cask up, and Lil will be the one to get that kill. In fact, he's close to level 6 now.
Mm-hmm.
So, not a bad pickup there for Mag in the side of Virtus Pro Polar. Although, they are pushing into mid lane with Kuroki, No Tail. He'll take one of the wolves and continue to right-click this tower down. With 36 stacks, this tower falls quickly.
Yep. And it looks like VPP are doing a good job keeping the farm up. If you look at the CS chart, they have four heroes in near the top of the charts.
Task bounces twice. That's it, though. No use to the death ward. It's not available. Puppy should fall here. Trap's going to go in as well. Are they going to turn this? Blink stop onto two. Double Edge is going to come momentarily. Now they ensnare into DK Phobos. The sentry ward on the deck. They need more damage. They're going to get it. Double Edge. Misery does fall, though. The stick charge saves his life. The Firefly Blink. Lasso for FNG is going to be there. And S4 is just trying to get closer. Flamebreak pushes him back. Lasso about to go. Will they need it? Actually, they just right click him and they get a triple kill for Kuroki using the raises. They take the tier 1 tower. Secret now. They're the ones running train on Virtus Pro Polar after.
Do you see Kuroki's item?
Of the ganks. That is a shadow amulet. I do see it.
Wait, does he actually have the full... Yeah, he actually has both those completed.
Full He's... Shadow Blade 13 minutes into the game.
What a... An odd item build, to say the least. Not something that we see too often.
I like this for
have
one
Have we ever
reason
seen it
particular.
In a pro game, actually?
Probably. I like this for one particular
for
reason.
Time.
The one support they have for Virtus Pro Polar is Lil, and he's poor.
That is
you
true.
You won't see Lycan building detection, and you could already see it going to work. FNG gets blown up. Now Kuroki just TP's away from Mag. There's no way they can kill him. Kuroki's fine. He will take the stun of the base, but he's already up to 1,200 gold as well, and okay.
Yep. Well, the Lothar's paying off there. They get the kill onto FNG's Lycan, and yeah, like you said, I suppose that is true. They only have one support hero. And it is a hero that really wants to get towards some items, especially that Aghanim Scepter. So forcing him to buy all these sentries pretty much guarantees that unless something weird happens, he's never going to get to that Aghanim's.
Secret are showing their stuff here in this third game. And honestly, we thought the draft and the lanes were a bit better for Virtus Pro Polar. But for now, Secret are executing the ganks they need to make. Again, the late game is probably secured for Virtus Pro Polar, but Kuroki and really the rest of the squad are not giving them a chance to get there. S4 yep. is going to blink lasso maybe on DK Phobos. Firefly's going to go through. Too far away, I think.
Trouble.
He's too far away unless he goes to the high ground here. Stampede.
Nope.
Blink. Lasso goes. They will catch him. Now Kroki's going to come through as well. Stomp now going to go the raise. Double edge. That's more than enough damage to get the kill. And DK Phobos' farm is halted yet another time.
Yeah, bat plus center is a very scary combination. He had fairly good positioning there, and it looked like he was actually going to live, but then just the simple stampede into bat rider blink. Just too much right now for this TA to handle, and TA's really not having any sort of effectiveness. You know, it's a hero that's supposed to dominate the lane and sort of snowball from there, but was in a dual lane up against a tri lane. And not really having the success that VPP maybe wanted. And it was their last pick, so it's not like they picked it early in the draft and then had to put it... See
you in the spring. Mag doesn't get the kill top on Puppy. He got caught out with Dove, by the way. Mag's made some really ridiculous plays this game, honestly. I think
he's 2-0 too.
The acquisition has been quite successful. Tier 1 tower is going to fall. All of the Tier 1s, with the exception of top, are gone. Kuroki is gonna right click Illidan once, and with the Shadow Blade extra damage, actually just takes off half of his health and then kills him with a raise and another right click. So Kuroki has a mega kill streak. He's up to 2,600 gold. And after you get your Shadow Blade, do you go for, say, something like a BKB? What do you pick up next for a Shadow Fiend?
Well, I know that. Okay, so the inventor of the Shadow or I remember who used to go Shadow Blade in professional games. It was the Chinese player CTY. He would go Shadowblade, Mask of Madness, Saint Jin Yasha, and Crit. But he's also a man and doesn't buy BKBs, so... we could see something similar come out. I'm probably not. It's probably just going to be a BKB, but...
He has enough money to buy one of the components of the BKB. He could buy a Mask of Madness outright. By the way, Misery Dream Coil, Death Ward going in, stop, doesn't connect, and he's dead, and... Yasha's picked up, so maybe SNY coming up for Kuroki,
yeah,
or just Samantha
still
style.
Has the Requiem of Souls, so... If he wants to, he can try to gank someone.
With Song? I think that's maybe what they're looking for now with No-Tail. Or they're just going to take Roche. Riptide plus 36 stacks of damage.
Can they actually do this, though?
No, they have a Medallion.
No-Tail's going to take a lot of damage from Roche.
They have a Medallion.
Yeah, they also have Presence of the Dark Lord.
I guess Riptide doesn't work on Roche. All right,
yeah,
well.
Riptide does not. Nope. This is known by VPP, though.
They have the Roche scouted by the Lycan Wolf, and now we can see coming in it is going to be DK Phobos. But S4 is like, you're not getting in here. Sentry to kill this Wolf here as quickly as possible. Song of the Siren is going to go. You're going to just actually use it defensively just to make sure they get a Stampede. They're going to maybe jump onto DK Phobos here. Who are they going to jump? Oh, they backing away? Silence coming in. Kuroki's in trouble. He's going to have to Shadowblade. They have Detection. Dust goes in. He's gone. That's his Aegis. Poison Nova goes in the backside. S4 is trying to get away. He has his TP. He's going to use it now. The cask. Not there. S4 TP's out. He's fine. Now they get off the ultimate, and Mag is low. They get the kill. Kuroki going to work. No-Till gets the kill on the other side of things with Mag going down and obviously FNG. No-Till's going to get right-click. It's a 2-for-2 exchange thus far. No further engagement coming through from either squad.
Mm-hmm.
Misery is really low.
Still a pretty good fight for VPP, considering they got the Aegis and 2-for-2. Not the worst in the world. It would have been nice if they were able to pick off Kuroki twice, but not going to be the case.
Yeah, that was tough. They realized that they didn't really want to fight that badly once the song was pretty much over, and they had to back away, and then they just got jumped on, and Mag got the kill. But good re-engage coming up from Secret. They make it somewhat even. And
yeah, the problem with that fight was that the Firefly was used offensively in this area to make sure that VPP couldn't actually contest the actual Roshan. But after that point, the song was used, and then no more Firefly, so S4 was pretty much out of luck at that point and couldn't cast anything. Didn't even get a lasso off.
Lasso would not have been successful at that point.
Yeah, wouldn't have done anything.
Now, No-Tail with Medallion, he has an Aquila as well. He might be able to build into a Force later on in this game, but we're talking very late game, so for him, it's really just about ensnares and good Nagasara and ultimates, so for now, it's a pretty, I'd say, even game, although Kuroki's net worth advantage actually gives the team a net worth advantage of 1,500, an experience advantage of about 4,000 for Secret as well. The Blink Daggers have been paying off, however, some really good counter initiations from Virtus Pro Polar, especially in that last situation. And I guess, what do you do in this scenario if you're Polar? Hopefully don't die and not lose Elden Storm Rage. Maybe there's a counter engage here. Mag actually is not going to go for a Dream Coil. He decides against it. So they just lose Illidan in the top lane. Manta's now done for Kuroki. And his damage is going to be pretty absurd at this point.
And Kuroki does go for that Manta build, like you said. I guess it's pretty good this game. It's going to allow him to take off refraction charges a bit more effectively. It's going to be good when fighting up against the Lycan so that he is not maybe sure which one is the real one. So I think the Manta is a good choice this game.
Raises are going to finish off some of these creeps. Kuroki is very farmed. 11,000 net worth, and the next closest is the Venomancer at 7,000. Although DK Phobos is starting to get to go.
FNG finally finishes the Vlads, but this is not really the type of impact that you want your Lycan to have.
He just farmed too slowly in the jungle.
Yeah,
he died a couple of times, and it was an issue.
It's not really his fault. It's just, I don't think jungle Lycan's any good. It takes too long.
Do you think if it went Wolves first, maybe it's a bit better, or do you have to go Hal first in that situation just to help out your team?
I think you go Wolves first, but I think he went Hal because they got the first blood. Like, he saved his skill point, and then when the Gale connected.
Ultimate cancel for Kuroki. He doesn't see Mag, I don't believe. No. Illidan is the one he's looking for. Ice Blast is maybe going to connect.
Oh, no,
ultimate getting charged. Illidan just going to get blown up. He throws up the poison of a Dream Coil. Kuroki did not expect Mag, who was invisible. The Death Whirl. Manta's out of it. Might get Mag. He will. Double kill. There's the song to cancel, but a bit too late. Where's the follow-up? They're going to get a lasso here on Lil. Or maybe they don't even need it. Blink Stomp should be enough here. They're going to find him. Lasso onto Phobos now as well. Drags him into the Firefly. The right-click, the ensnare coming through. The Maldic came in. Look at Phobos trying to right-click down Misery, but it's not enough. They get four kills off the back end of that one ultimate from Kuroki. The Requiem did some work. Although FNG does get the Tier 1 tower in that mid lane as he was ulting. He pops it off quickly and then just heads the hell out of there. And he's going to maybe go for the Tier 1 bottom as well.
Yeah, 4-for-1. And Lycan did get the mid tower, so I mean, that's decent for VPP, but trading 4-for-1 at this point is not what they want to be doing.
TP rotations. He's out of shapeshift. FNG's dead. Oh, yeah, he's very dead. S4 is going to spot him easily. Flame Break and Misery double edges and make sure that he gets that kill. So the tower is now in deny range as well, too. So
Misery's been playing so well this series. His last choke performance,
man.
And the center has been quite good for Secret this game as well.
If we've learned anything, his hero pool is quite wide. Offlane Juggernaut getting first blood.
I've seen him. He's played pretty much every offlane hero, I think. ET, Windrunner, Centaur, Puck,
oh,
even.
God. His Misery Elder Titan yesterday was amazing, yep. to put it mildly. That won them a couple of games, I think. So, yeah, I mean, Secret have now just an extraordinarily large hero pool. You have so many different... I mean, these players have played almost every single role, it feels like, at least for Proki, Misery. Notale has played very good core roles as well, so... For Virtus Pro Polar, this is, again, not an easy matchup. They're down 2-0, and this is a team that was clowning on Evil Geniuses in that semifinal series. They're not having such luck anymore. A lot of that was because of the Slark coming out, which, in that second game today, got shut down heavily. And that's unfortunate. Again, Illidan must not feel very good about that, so...
Yep. And now on a hero that he's probably not particularly comfortable with either, on the Venomancer. I don't think I've seen him play this too many times. Usually when they run this, it's DK Phobos playing it, but they did pick the TA, so that's definitely DK Phobos' hero when they pick this hero.
It's not really accomplishing anything, though. I mean, Refraction has not saved him. Meldstrike has been useless.
It's not
They've
really
had vision,
his fault
so.
Either. It's I just... These last picks for VP in the last two games have been very strange to me. Like, this
what
last
pick,
TA...
This game? Oh,
TA.
Yeah.
And then in the previous game, they last picked Beastmaster. And honestly, both picks have done pretty much nothing. And you really want your last pick to be strong, especially because it's not counterable at that point, and just a bit odd from VPP, I think.
You have to do something crazy, though, sometimes. Yeah. Make something work. If one thing doesn't work, you have to try more and more solutions and see what happens at the end. But unfortunately, it's just not been their game these past few games. Again, though, they're still in this one. We're talking as if a set of racks is gone, but really, Virtus Pro Polar are in a pretty good spot, despite being down about only 4,000 net worth. They will find a last, though. Meanwhile, the Dream Coil, FNG gets caught out. There's going to be the shift, but the ensnare immediately. And now look at Croaky with a double damage rune, just right clicks him down. If he didn't have 36 soul in that, he does now, certainly. And he's going to chase after the Storm Rage on the Venomancer. Poison Nova does get off, but Croaky's not going to go any further than that. The Shadow Blade, they had Vision. Yep. The Maledict on Misery, so they're okay with one kill onto FNG, and they'll back away. Although S4 is getting chased down by these wolves.
Good thing that they had a psionic trap there. Otherwise, the song would have connected on two or three heroes and probably gotten Secret even further ahead in more kills.
Just the one kill, though, going their way, and Croaky backs up to heal up as well as Misery, I think. And actually, he might just have healing from Trembles secure him some HP. So that's going to be the case. Illidan in the top lane continues to see. They're trying to push to a certain extent. They have the Plague Wards to put some pressure on the Tier 2 tower. Meanwhile, DK Phobos is running around the map trying to find farm.
Why did they ward up here? They actually warded up here, but I'm not exactly sure for what purpose.
Mag has sat up here a couple of times, and he's been jumping in and out getting kills.
No, VPP warded up there.
Yeah, I know. And maybe they want Vision of Mag as he jumps in occasionally, because I think Mag is... Or not Mag, Misery, excuse
Misery,
me.
Misery, okay.
My bad.
I was a little confused.
I got my M players confused. My M offlane players confused. Speaking of Mag. Hello, sir. How are you today? I hope you enjoy a good stomp, maybe. Nope, Lasso's going to be the choice. Lasso, Firefly, Stomp, Double Edge. That's been the combination that they've needed all
VPP
game.
VPP are struggling against the double Blink Dagger from Secret. There's not even much they can do. It's not like they have a Shadow Demon or a Bane or something that can just disrupt even slightly during these chain stuns.
A long time ago, I think. The Yule Scepter might have been enough to save Mag. I doubt it. But Yules would be very good in this situation. Or Song, like they have the Song counter-initiation from Notale. The fact that they have it on their team is even more frustrating. And Kuroki just goes top. 36 souls, Vance is done. He's going to go for a BKB next with his Ogre Club or an SNY. We'll see which one. And they just clear this creep wave too easily. And look at, Virtus Pro Polar are not even close to defending this. FNG's going to come up here to the high ground, but no BKB for him. The Medallion is going to go on to an Illusion, so they spot him out. Misery's actually waiting in the wings. He's looking for an initiation, but Misery gets spotted out. Now his Blink Dagger's on cooldown because of the wolves. And Misery's like, what's hitting me? Four staff, he's still looking for FNG. FNG's going to pop the shapeshift. Ice Blast coming in, not going to connect. It will hit on Mag and FNG, actually. Phase Shift, Dream Coil onto Misery. Now the Song counter initiation is going to come in. Croaky is about to pop off with his Requiem of Souls. Here we go. The R button's being pressed. Illidan taking the brunt of the damage. Now S4 comes in. Poison Nova gets off, but Illidan should still die. The Flame Break going to work. Now the Death Ward, Croaky has to back away. He does get the Lothars off and backs out. Meanwhile, Death Ward connecting, but doesn't kill anybody. Croaky's getting low, and they do get the kill. Mag had spotted him out. They dusted, and they get the kill onto Lothar's Kuroki. Also, S4 backing away. He's low. The poison over did work. Illusory Orb. Good blink from S4. He'll get out for the time being. Four staff on cooldown. Now off cooldown. Decides to try to go. He actually misses his flame break completely. Stomp coming in from the backside. Now they get the lasso and the initiation coming out with the centaur. They get the kill. They get two kills, in fact. S4 and Misery combining up with double edge and lasso yet again. And they just blow up and they turn it around. It should have been a 1-for-1. And it turns into a 3-for-1, but for the wrong team. As Secret, they get everything going their way.
Yeah, that fight actually looked very promising for VPP. They got so many heroes low with the Venomancer ult, but not able to finish most of them off and end up overextending and feeding away two additional kills to Secret, ending up for a 3-for-1 advantage towards Secret. So very nicely played by S4, Misery, as well as Puppy with the Ice Blast coming in towards the end.
Roshan's up. Traps will spot this out, however, and Secret will probably put down a Sentry Ward in the near future.
Yeah, they have
actually has a gem, so yeah. Fill the side traps quickly and one. They're gonna use both of them, I think.
Yeah.
Nope, just kidding.
He doesn't matter. Well, it doesn't even matter.
It's fine.
I guess you don't feed up the one gold. So, if he pops it instead of letting him kill it.
Just kind of a BM play, it feels like. It's like, yep. You're not getting this. You
that
bastard.
One gold.
It's denied. BKB picked up four DK Phobos for the Templar Assassin. They'll TP towards the bottom lane. They are going to contest this. Lasso, though, goes on the other side of things. Illidan Stormage is going to get caught, but where's the follow-up? Ensnare first. Venomous Gale misses. Misery actually blinked to the high ground, and they flame break him up to the high ground. Some miscommunication there. That was kind of a silly play. Misery's like, do I go to the low ground, or do I go to the high ground? Or
he thought the bat was actually going to make it to the high ground, but unfortunately not able to do so. But ends up actually flame breaking him up in the end, and Misery's like trying to walk down, but
Misery's clowning around. He like forced himself up here to the high ground for whatever reason, then he just blinks out.
He was checking for a ward.
A ward right now. Yep. Top three in net worth now are Secret. They have eclipsed the net worth graph by quite a large margin. It was 4,000 a minute ago. It's about to be 10,000.
Did you know you can blink up here now?
Where? The Uber Cliff or the super good ward
that,
spot?
That
yeah. Thank God. What a broken ward spot that was.
It was pretty broken. You had to either have a spell that gives vision or put an observer ward to deward that, which was kind of ridiculous.
It doesn't make sense that you couldn't blink up there. That actually makes me mad. I'm not sure why that was the case. And there was apparently you talked about this
I think
talked about it, but there's at the Ancients on the Dire side, there is a ward that you could place that is uncounterable or something, I think.
I'm not sure exactly where it is, but there's a ward that you can place that you can't sentry it without actually blocking the camp.
They fixed that too.
Oh, they did? Okay, thank
you. Yeah,
God.
They fixed that. Because
that was so ridiculous.
I just read that patch notes. I'm like, well, that's everything everyone talked about at the summit. Like, Zai talked about the 0-minute runes. They got fixed. AUI talked about those ward spots. They got fixed.
Yeah, it was definitely clear that they talked to. They took a lot more professional player input. They always do, but this patch, it was particularly evident.
I think one thing, and I've talked about this with other people, one thing that's going to be going the way of the dinosaur soon is attack modifiers, orbs. I talked to Merlini about this, and apparently
they're pretty much all going away.
Merlini's just like, yeah, those things are useless. They should not exist in Dota, so.
Yeah, everything's just going to be a flat. I mean, SNY, Diffusal have already been changed. Scotty, I believe, as well.
SNY changed, right?
I think Deso, Mjolnir,
Scotty.
Lifesteal, right?
Well, I guess
because Lifesteal doesn't work when you proc those.
Yeah.
No, Scotty doesn't.
Yeah.
Unless you have Deso, I believe, or some. There's some weird interactions still.
Attack modifiers are just confusing and dumb in general, I think, for the most part, but.
Yeah, I'm also not 100% sure because they keep changing them.
Secret now rushing down mid. They're looking for the final tier 2 tower. And then it may be time for them to go to the high ground with the Aegis on Kuroki. BKB now done. He doesn't go for the SNY, unsurprisingly. And S4 sitting at the high ground, they throw up the side trap just to get some vision. S4 Fireflies up. He's looking for an initiation. Might find Phobos. They see him, I think. Maybe not. Ice Blast comes in just to push them all back. And this is a very tough defense. Illidan can come in. Blaster's going to come through. It was on the bag, so he can't drink pull, counter initiate. They blow him up. No buyback either. Melt quick from DK Phobos. They want to counter initiate, and they want to maybe try to bring down DK Phobos with his BKB. Song going to work. Mercury stunned up with the cast as was bouncing through. Lil was about to die. Now they jump in, poisoned over with Illidan, but that's all he gets off before getting stomped up and right-click down. No tail will TP away. Puppy not going to be so lucky. FNG holding this strong. Buyback coming in from Lil. He still has his death ward on the other side of things. FNG chasing after Misery. Poison over the right-click. The stomp going to go. He has blink in 1 second. Will he make it out in time? It looks like yes. Going to blink to the side, and he should be able to TP away. Not that he has one. He actually has force. Maybe they go in for another kill. Lasso's not available for another 20 seconds, but they're going to turn their attention to FNG. FNG's like, oh god, what have I gotten myself into? Stomp not there. Now the force staff. Stomp misses coming through. FNG still alive, juking around the tree line now that it's broken with the Firefly. Double Edge goes in. Misery does get the kill. Wicked Sick. Now they have Kroki. Shadowblade ultimating, getting a kill, it looks like, onto the Witch Doctor. Phobos, the last one alive. There's the Lothar's Refraction's broken. Back up again. Now broken once more. Lasso back up, and he's dead. It is a full five-man wipe, although Mag is back alive. Waiting Rift. S4 is back to full health. And they are just taking this fight anywhere, literally inside the base, outside the base, top lane, middle lane, wherever you want it, Secret will kill you. And that's what they're telling everybody right now.
Yeah, Secret are just doing a great job. It seems like after the teamfights break down is where they really have the advantage, and doing a really good job getting additional kills after the teamfight, pretty much mostly due to the overextension, I would say, from VPP. Just doesn't seem like VPP are too into this game almost.
Yeah, I was gonna say they're not really in this anymore. It feels like
I feel like they're psychologically broken. And honestly, I think a lot of it comes down to the first game. I think that
it
was a draft they were really comfortable with. They hadn't lost with those heroes, I don't believe, and you know, losing a game like that can really affect your mentality.
By all means, they should have won that game.
Yeah,
that was their game to win,
and we would have had a completely different series.
Absolutely, I think they get the drafts they want. That, and again, it comes down to the Lycan last pick as well for Virtus Pro Polar in that second game. And then they just got shut down because Mag didn't contribute much. Their lanes weren't very good. The lanes here were good, had a good idea, but Brokey just got too far ahead. And it really comes down to, I think, the blinks. Both of those blinks came out at about 9 to 10 minutes. And then from that point on, you knew S4 and Misery were going to be a force to be reckoned with. And they were. And they killed everybody. It's not even like No Tail took the game over like he did with his Disruptor. Puppies hit a couple of good Ice Blasts in combination with those heroes, but they really don't need the Ice Blast to secure the kills. So if anything, it is the 10-minute Blink Dagger coming out from Misery and S4 that have won them this part of the game, at least. Yep. As it is still progressing, and we have yet to see a Rax fall or anything, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Secret definitely doing a great job with these two Blink Daggers, and we talk about it all the time. The more Blinks you have, the more effective they become. Just with how, because you can just, if one of your blink heroes has some sort of lockdown or stun, then the other ones can just jump in, deal some additional damage, and you can just blow someone up instantly instead of having to wait for your team to arrive. And they currently have three blink daggers as well as the global from the AA, so able to deal a lot of damage once they initiate. Yeah, I think it's just a matter of time before this game ends. There's no Rax taken, so there is some hope for VPP if they can just hold on into the super late game.
I mean, FNG certainly can carry with a Lycan, but the problem is he's so far behind in terms of net worth. I mean, again, another 10,000 net worth lead at least against FNG. Kuroki's up to 19,000 currently, so we saw this last game. We see it again. DK Phobos is trying to do whatever he can, but his refraction's not doing anything. His damage is minimal. His BKB, which he might have just picked up, he'd already used it once. It didn't work out in his favor. I think there was a song while that was happening, so. Mod packs were, there we go. Excellent, that's what I was looking for. I was about to say, where are our jokes? We got one. Guys, feel free to use these. These are high quality jokes.
A dyslexic man walks into a bra.
Mm-hmm. Do you get that? Is that too highbrow for your?
I don't get it. Isn't dyslexia where you read backwards?
Yes.
Well, bar backwards is rab.
It's not backwards. It's dyslexia. I believe is I believe it's just your word. The words are jumbled. It doesn't have to be backwards.
Oh, okay.
I don't think that's backwards. How dyslexia works. I don't think your brain's like it has to be backwards.
Maybe it like flips around words. One was assaulted. I like that one. That one's good.
Man, these are some good jokes.
It's especially relevant because players are salty.
That's true.
In general.
Yeah. Maybe not this game, though.
No, maybe not in professional matches, but Dota players are definitely a salty group of individuals.
You seen EG lately?
G?
EG.
Oh, EG, yeah.
No, G EG is not salty.
No, G doesn't definitely seem not like a salty guy.
He seems like a good guy. Yep. EG in general are salty people. They're salty when they're not playing Dota. New Universe is just... He's got this quiet, mysterious aura around him.
Calm, the rest cool, of EG, and collected.
Like, yeah, exactly. Like, even Zai gets salty from time to time, I feel like. He'll be playing, like, Street Fighter against Bruno or, like, Dakota.
Emotionally unstable group of
I wouldn't
individuals.
Call that. Let's not go that far, man. I think you're talking about Ix Mike.
What? Not Ix Mike. Ix Mike is just...
Is he your boy?
He gets so salty sometimes.
He really does. Is he your boy, by the way? I'm curious.
Who?
Ix Mike.
Ix Mike? Yeah, he's my boy.
Who's your boy?
I don't know. I'm friends with Mike.
Okay. I know you and Sam are tight as well.
We used to be.
Oh, he changed.
As you get less and less relevant, yeah. He talks to you less and less.
So that's why he's not talking to me anymore.
Oh, man. It's actually so true. It's pretty funny.
He hung out with me at the summit. It was fun. It was a good time.
I'm sure everyone's different in IRL, right?
Yes. Yes, I think Pycat's very good at playing games. Actually, I have a story. It's actually unreal how good Merlini is at just picking up a game and playing it. As flamey as he may be sometimes in his casting, he is, number one, very good at Dota. Number two, he's very good at any other game he picks up. So, for those of you that don't know, Smash Brothers is kind of a big thing in the Dota community. Uh-huh. At least it became a big thing after the documentary.
I know people play it at LANs and stuff.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we played a lot of Smash in the past year, whether at TI4, where Hotbed had a full room of people playing Smash with, like, Ken from the Melee community.
That was pretty funny.
That was cool. Or even at, like, the BTS house during the TI4 qualifiers, and especially at the summit as well. And so the first time that Ben picked up Smash Melee... and I'm somebody that's not really as, you know, I'm not super skilled. I know the advanced techniques, but, you know, I've been playing for a while. And then Merlini just picks up the game. He plays Falco because, you know, that's like the, I'm trying to think of a relevant, that's like the death prophet, I guess, of Melee's is Falco. And he literally proceeds to just whoop my ass. And I'm not the only one he did that to. That's the problem. Like, it'd be okay. Like, I could admit that I'm bad because guess what? I am bad. But then, like, he just picks up the game and whoops everyone's ass with Falco, not knowing how to L cancel, not knowing how to tech, not knowing DI, not knowing wave dashing. The foreign language is real, but a lot of the advanced techniques he didn't know. And then I made the mistake of teaching him these advanced techniques at the summit. I did a bit better, but he still just kicks ass. And then, like, he plays other games and he just is actually ridiculous at them. He played Gang Beasts for the first time and he won. Actually got second place EGM1, the tournament there at the summit. But I guess that's not only for Ben, though. That's just for Dota players in general. Dota players seem to have a affinity for playing video games and or games in general and just destroying people. It's kind of ridiculous.
I think it's just being a professional in one game. It translates over to many games.
Because
you
true.
Do, like, the way you learn the game is the same, I think.
If only I had that talent, man. My talent is for camera control and talking about what's happening on the map currently. And sometimes making funny jokes, but really that doesn't happen too often. That's actually Montpack's talent. We're back into the game. The pause is it's over, thank God. Didn't seem that long, but game number three, still underway, 34 minutes into the game. Again, this is for all the marbles, Dota Pick Grand Final, which, by the way, big shout out to everyone that has made this tournament a success. It's been so much fun casting. You and I have been doing so many of the games. Again, just want to give a bit of a shout out before we move on here.
It's been a fun tournament to cast, that's for sure.
The viewers who have joined us every day. Satanic finished up for Kuroki, so yeah, this is going to be frightening. The regen is real. The lifesteal is real. Manta BKB, which is at a 8-second duration. Pretty damn good considering he's been doing work without it for the most part. And he has about 300 damage coming through. 151 base, 138 bonus, green damage.
And I'm not sure that they can kill Kuroki with the Satanic now. Sure, they might be able to get him low, but once he pops the Satanic, he's going to be gaining so much life.
There's
like
no burst
said,
damage.
Sitting at 300 damage.
They have a lot of prolonged damage. They are going to catch out somebody in the mid lane. Phobos pops his BKB. He gets out. There's no lasso coming through, I don't believe. They might have used it, and then he would have BKB'd and TP'd afterwards. But
yeah, they used the lasso first, and then he BKB TP'd, and there's nothing to cancel it at that point. But the siege now begins in the bottom lane for Secret. As Kuroki pops the Manta, starts wailing on this tower. And this
Assault Karas is up. And they
what does DK do? I mean, what does VP do? I keep seeing DK's name and then I get...
RIP. Tier 3 tower's gonna fall. Misery does get cast up. And I think you have to fight somehow. But a fight here and you lose and it's probably over. In fact, No Tail is gonna initiate the fight. They say they've had enough. They're gonna go for it right now. Riptide. Actually, they just pushed them back into the well. It's a free set of racks for Secret. They can't even fight on top of this. Illidan's not TPing home. He doesn't want to. He does have a TP, but he's not using it. So the first set of racks now finally taken down. The Assault Kuras picked up perfectly for Misery. And they also have a pipe as well. So there is absolutely no way that they take down Kuroki. Poison Nova is a lot of the damage. They have a lot of prolonged damage. No real immediate burst damage coming out. That's how you have to kill him. And they just don't have that. Melt Strike's not really doing that much. Dream Pool's kind of falling off.
Really
so.
From TA, I would say.
Yeah.
Like if TA can get... you know, 4 or 5 auto attacks, he's going to do a tremendous amount of damage with the meld, as well as even picking up a chrysalis, so possibly for those RNG crits.
The armor reduction for meld is 8, and then you have an Assault Kuras, and he's already really, I mean, he has 30 armor with Assault Kuras aura. Yeah. 31 armor, actually. Venomous Gale misses. I actually might have connected. He gets stampeded away. Looks like it did hit. Misery's forcing himself, blinking forward, looking for a hero. He's going to find Illidan Stormrage. Little throwing up the casks, going to bounce between the illusions. Poison Nova does go. Death Ward, Misery taking a lot of this damage. Not done yet. The song goes to stop the Death Ward. FNG going to work. They're trying to take down Phobos and FNG with this Song of the Siren. But S4 might be the one going down here, getting right click Melt Strike. It does fall and kills him. Mag Dream Coil. He's going to Yule Scepter up in the air. 1-for-1 exchange so far. Buyback for S4. It's actually 2-for-1. FNG staying alive. Ultimate from Kuroki actually lifts. Maybe hits on Mag, and they do get the kill on him. And the phase shift was not there. Phobos is trying to fight up. The refraction, the ensnare going through. Phobos has no BKB. Kuroki pops his Satanic, goes to work, gets a kill. Looking for Mag now. Is bought back, and Mag is about to fall as well. And this might be the end of the game. Secret are overrunning the base. Venomous Gale goes. Illidan Stormrage needs to blink away and gets out into trouble. But Secret are taking down the Tier 3 tower. They're going to take down the Rax in a second. Puppy has to go home. But at this point in time, they are about to be your champions. The grand finals will be taken maybe in 3-0. They just have to take a couple more Raxes, a couple more fights. They have to keep going. Secret are almost there. Virtus Pro Polar defending with everything they've got right now. FNG running forward. They don't have DK Phobos, their biggest damage dealer. They don't have the poison of it. Now it gets popped off, and it does some work to S4. Lasso back in. Now they're going to bring him down with right clicks alone. It looks like Ice Blast's going to sail through. Going to connect onto every hero here. Now Kuroki popped off. No Satanic. His Manta style goes through. He's in some trouble. FNG actually goes to work, and Kuroki can't stay alive, but he kills him with the Requiem at the end. The Immense Illusion's going to Illidan, but No Tail now alone trying to get out. No Song. He's going to try to maybe deny himself, juke his way through the trees, but the Illusion Orb kills him, and they do defend. It is not Secret taking the game just yet. It is Virtus Pro Polar with a big Poison Nova, and the Satanic being on cooldown, meaning that Virtus Pro Polar live yet once more.
Yeah, but they end up getting 3 wrecks in the end, as well as 2 Tier 3 towers, so... I just expect this to be a matter of time. They're probably going to go for Roshan. They know that is going to be available. And then that's probably just going to spell the end of the game. I'm not sure. VP have sort of ran out of gas at this point. And with another Aegis as well, there's probably nothing they can do at that point. Although Kuroki does not have a slot to put the Aegis in.
Does he need it though?
First world problems.
Yeah, seriously. That's how farmed he is. Ice Blast. Stomp does connect, but Ice Blast won't. DK Phobos is too tanky for that anyways to work out. Trap, and he might turn this on to Misery. Misery definitely does not have buyback, but DK Phobos does not want to chase. He doesn't know who's behind Misery currently.
And Secret scouts out, S4 scouts out that Roshan is available, and it probably is going to be taken as soon as Kuroki respawns. Looks like they're preparing for Rosh, and then it's going to be a simple mid lane push. And... yeah, I think VP are just stalling. You know, maybe Secret makes a couple of mistakes so they can get back into this game and get it towards that later stage where we said that VP had the chance. But at the rate the game is going, Secret definitely should have an easy time closing out this game.
We talk about Secret, we talk about how good they are in the late game, and that's We're not lying about that. Secret have done so well. You talked about their win rate was about 75% or something. We can get an actual confirmation on what their win rate is from Wattpacks, our stats man. He's good at jokes, but he's also good at stats too, so. Kuroki looking to get to 36 souls quickly, and then he'll head over to the Roach Pit. In fact, they don't even really need him. They're just going to do it without him. But the problem with this is that there is a gank squad from Virtus Pro Polar.
He actually doesn't have buyback right now.
If he dies here, Nate might be able to hold without him, but I'm afraid. They have gems on the side of Virtus Pro Polar. In fact, Mag is the one with it, and he's in the trees currently. Kuroki could easily get spotted out here, but the rest of his team will be on their way soon as Roshan is... It's the longest Roshan in the history of Roshes.
But it's taking them a long time to do it, as they don't really have any physical DPS on any of these heroes.
S4 is going to receive the cheese, Mizri will receive the Aegis as he drops the Vitality Booster, and that'll be picked up by Puppy, it looks like, for the time being, and they were bringing out the Courier but decided against it. Kuroki pops off the Shadow Blade, DK Phobos runs away in fear. Mag is still in the top lane, split pushing, and now the assault on the mid lane is going to begin with Secret heading back towards their Butterfly completed for Kuroki. Buyback status. Who has it? Who doesn't? There is one buyback for Virtus Pro Polar. It is DK Phobos. The fact that Secret don't have one, not necessarily as big of an issue. S4 lassos up onto FNG. He does get the shapeshift off. The Ensnare. He also got his BKB. BKB duration about to fall. Still been, a couple of seconds here. Poison Nova stomp will connect just in time. Double-edged flame break. They get the kill. FNG's dead again with no buyback. Illidan's going to fall as well. Two down, and now Secret are going to assault the base. And the set of racks mid is gone. Set of racks bottom have been cleared out for some time now. Top lane is the only lane left to go for, or they can go for tier fours and try to finish this game out, or they can just clear up all of the heroes and go from there. But Kuroki pops off the Shadow Blade, he'll head to the top lane with the Assault Kuros, the armor reduction, the towers will melt like butter. Now there's a Dream Coil, but Kuroki's still up and he has Satanic as well. There's no way that they're bringing him down. They're gonna jump in with DK Phobos, he'll try to fight with his BKB. Kuroki mans up as well. Blink Stomp, Lil's gonna get brought down, no death ward for him, no buyback either. There's the song going in. They want DK Phobos, but his BKB wears off and now they turn it off and go to work, and boom, they just destroy him. Virtus Pro Polar's FNG trying to get away. The right click, no shapeshift. He's about to fall in. Secret now, one kill away, a couple racks away, a couple tier fours away, or a GG away for finishing this series off. 3-0, Mag gonna jaunt into the well. They're gonna well die potentially. Mizri backs away. There's the tier three tower gone. Now the racks is flipped up. They pop off. Kuroki with just a Requiem of Souls, just out of pure joy now that they maybe won the game. And the Rax is about to fall. Kuroki doing what he can. The Poison Nova goes in, and No-Tail might fall here, but Illidan, his last gasp, he's dead. Buyback status is not there. Lasso, BKB, Phobos, and the GG is called, and Secret are going to be your Dota Pit Season 2 winners. With such a great group stage showing, they get the bye, they get to the semifinals, and a tough series against Virtus Pro, they take them down. 3-1, and boom, they destroy Virtus Pro Polar in quick succession. 3-0 F4L. Wow, what a series coming up from Team Secret.
Yeah, really strong showing coming up from Secret in the grand finals. 3-0-ing Virtus Pro Polar. I think a lot of it has to come down to that.